Elhamdülillahi Rabbil Alemin. Ve salatu ve selamu ala Resulina Muhammedin ve ala alihi ve sahbihi ecmain. Rabbi şrahli sadri ve yessirli emri ve ahlul ukdeten min lisani yefkahu kavli. Dear students, we will talk about in this lesson interpretation of the Quran by the companions, by the prophet's companions. Some companions had difficulty in understanding certain Quranic verses. In our previous lesson, we talked about Adi bin Hatim's experience. He thought that the white thread and the black thread were really threads. So in reality, it was the thread was for down, min al-fajr in Arabic. But he thought that they were real threads, and he took two threads, white and black one, and he put them under his pillow, and he waited for the time to clarify which one is white, which one is red. A darkness he tried to experience, but in reality he didn't grasp the meaning very well. It is not like that. It was metaphorical, and he couldn't get the meaning very well. But were all the companions of the prophet the same? No, some of them were getting the meaning better. Some of them, like Adi, had difficulties in understanding the verses. The Quran was read and recited in the Qurayshi dialect. There were other dialects as well. For example, Musa. Some of the Arabs say Musi. Also, there are some different pronunciations as well. Sometimes they choose another pronunciation. For example, Quran. Some of the Arabs, they say Quran. They although when they writing, they say use alif in Arabic. But in pronunciation, some of them said Quran. But they were rare, they were not a big group. So they have got different pronunciations, dialects. Sometimes they were choosing different words to express the meaning. Because of those differences, there were some different understandings among Arabs. The companion's interpretation was often rather personal. He means that they tried to understand the verses and they gave their opinions. It doesn't mean that they got everything from Prophet Muhammad, but some scholars say that if the companions of the Prophet Muhammad said something, in a great possibility, they got this meaning from the Prophet. He gives an example for different approaches among the companions of the Prophet Muhammad. For example, the word muttaqi. The term muttaqi, according to Ibn Mas'ud, one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad, muttaqi means believers, mu'minun. Ibn Abbas says, those who fear God's punishment, Jahannam, for example, and seek his mercy by Rahmah, by believing in what he had sent. He gave another meaning. Are they contradictory? No, they aren't, but they are different. In such interpretations, each companion was putting forward his personal view or opinion. According to the writer, Ibn Mas'ud, Ibn Abbas said something about the word muttaqi. They are different, and those different opinions belong to them. Belong to each of them. Often it was their ijtihad, their opinion, according to writer, what might be called the spirit of the Quran and the prophet as they understood it. So why were their approaches different, for example, about the word muttaqi? Because they thought, they tried to understand the verses, and they presented their own views about the verses and how did they understand the Quran, how did they understand the Prophet. In this axis, they gave their ideas. Interpretation of the Quran by the successors, tabi'un, tabi'in, the ones who come after the companions of the Prophet Muhammad. The death of the Prophet meant new Muslims had to rely on leading companions. After the Prophet Muhammad's passing away, he died, what happened? Muslims need help in understanding the religion. So they considered his companions' approaches and views. In Iraq, Syria, Egypt, and Yemen, Mecca, Medina, there were Prophet Muhammad's companions, and they were considered as the authority in understanding the verses. It was the students of the companions who became the third most important group of exponents, followers of the Quran, the successors, tabi'un or tabi'in. As pupils of leading companions, and successors were the students of the Prophet's companions. Where were they? They were in Mecca, Medina, Iraq. Mecca, who was in Mecca? Famous one, Ibn Abbas. And he has got influential pupils in Islamic sciences, especially in Quran exegesis. Who were they? Atta, Mujahid, Ikrimah. In Medina, Ubay bin Ka'b ve Ibn Mes'ud in Iraq. His students, Al-Hasan al-Basri, he is famous as Al-Hasan. In general, in Islamic sources, we see him as Al-Hasan. They don't say Al-Hasan al-Basri. Why? Because he is very famous. If you say Al-Hasan, it means that Al-Hasan al-Basri. Another student, Ibrahim al-Nakhai, for Ibn Mas'ud in Iraq. They say Ibrahim al-Nakhai was the teacher of Abu Hanifa. Similar to the companions, the successors had a somewhat personal approach to the interpretation of the Quran. He said that the Prophet Muhammad's companions had different opinions about the verses. Why? Because they were their ijtihad. They tried to understand the verses, and sometimes they understood in different ways. Like that, the successors, tabi'un or tabi'in, did the same thing. For example, Qatada, although he was a successor, he was not from among the companions of the Prophet Muhammad, he didn't say that whatever I found from the companions, I will tell the same. He didn't say. He presented his own approach as well. For example, Muttaqi. What does Qatada said? Who believes in the unseen? Muttaqi, ghaib in Arabic. Praise, salah, and outlays money in the cause of God, infaq. He gives money, he gives charity money. He is muttaqi. Umar bin Abdulaziz says, one of the successors, taqwa is avoiding, keeping away what God has prohibited and performing what God made obligatory, wajib. He defined taqwa is like that. If you practice Islam, you are muttaqi, according to Umar bin Abdulaziz. There is no agreement among Muslims on the level of authority enjoyed by the successors in interpreting the Quran. Some think that Prophet Muhammad, the companions, and the successors, they are authority, they accept. But some says, oh, the successors are different. They are not authority. If we consider their approaches related to the verses, sometimes we can find their ideas true, sometimes we don't find, no problem. We choose something, so something, no, they are authoritative as well, like our prophet and then his companions. The next one are the successors. Ebu Hanife is the leader of Hanafit school, Madhab in Arabic. He was free to choose from among their views. He is like, he thinks like that. He chooses the successors' approaches. Sometimes he obeys them, sometimes he puts his own idea. Ibn Taymiyyah, one of the famous scholars, argued that the tafsir of the successors considered authoritative. So his approach is different from Ebu Hanife. Ebu Hanife considered the successors' opinions are the ones can be chosen or not. We are free to choose their approaches. But Ibn Taymiyyah says no, they are authoritative if we find the views of the successors, we should consider important their approaches. Inshallah, in our next lesson, we will continue from tradition-based tafsir to textualism.